Arnel Tixon, Counselor, Chairman Apolion Calatrava, and our guest speaker, Mrs. Celia Pereza Palos. Our beloved parents, teachers, fellow graduates, friends, ladies and gentlemen, good morning.
Good morning.
My heart is filled with so much emotion right now as I stand here. But I know that this is a rare moment for a student like me. So allow me to share with you a part of me. I am a child of an overseas Filipino worker. I was barely 7 years old when my dad left us to work abroad. A decision that my parents had to make just to give us a good life. That is why, for someone like me, who has always been a daddy's girl, it's kind of tough because just like any other child, there were times that I wish. Once I got home, my dad would be there to ask me how my day had been.
Ay, nako, nakakainis!
During the time that I was winning in different competitions, I would have wanted him to be here and share my victory with the rest of the family. But that wasn't our case. Yes, without the access of the modern technology, when we could always keep in touch. Yes, my dad always comes home during Christmas, and we could also visit him during summer. But in my heart, I know that nothing would compare if he was physically here in all the days of my growing up years, and we could talk in person, just like most father and daughter do. I am sharing this to all of you just to let you know that even if I have been in this situation for the past 6 years of my life, here I am as your class valedictorian. I feel severe. I took our situation as an inspiration for me to become the best student that I could be. Friends, just like all my fellow graduates here, I was one of those expectant children when I first set foot in this school. At first, Valerie Medjo wasn't included in the choices of schools where I was supposed to enroll. Fortunately, my grandma, Mrs. Virginia Du, convinced my mom to enroll me here. She was told that this school is blessed with brilliant and dedicated teachers and students. And whenever there is a school competition, the Norwegian students always bring home the bacon. True enough, I am one of the living testimonies. When I was in grade 1, our team ranked 1 in both MTOP written and oral competition. I was the top scorer then. This MTOP saga continues until we reach grade 6, and we never went home without an award. I even had the chance to represent our division in the regional level in Marathon, Campus Journalism, and STEM Skills Sales Inventory. It is also a privilege on my part to be the school speller from grades 1 to 6, wherein 4 times I won first place in the district level and got to represent our district in the division level. Just this year, I am the top notcher of the Laguna College entrance examination for the upcoming freshman. Just this, are just some of the proofs that this school has poured me a fountain of knowledge and wisdom which enabled me to become victors in most of my endeavors. But just like any beginning, there is an inevitable ending. Our 6 years of studying here has finally come to completion. But we should always keep in mind that this is not over yet. It's just another step towards our future. Learning is a gift from God to prepare us and make better of our lives. Our theme, Your Gift of Learning, our tool for nation building, is truly embodied by this school. Our nation needs new, fresh minds and talents to rebuild and to cope up with a fast-changing world. And it will all be coming from us, young, new generation. With this, I am urging all of my fellow graduates to continue studying, strive hard, and become the person that we aim to be. And lastly, in behalf of my fellow graduates, I would like to say thank you. Thank you to all our teachers who became our second parents for the past 6 years. Whatever we achieve in our lives, you will always be part of it. Hats off to all of you. To our all-beloved parents, for without all of you, we wouldn't be here to celebrate and cherish this moment. With special mention to my mama, Tara Marcelevera, for being always on my side.
Oh, no, I don't know.
For being always on my side whenever there is a school competition and activities 24/7. Thank you, Mama. Your sacrifices will always be received in my heart. And to my mommy, Mrs. Lisa Gancia, whose presence may not be always visible in school, para kasi para condition na makikita ang beauty mo eh. But mommy, little did they know that I owe it in your loving arms, the Mariella Aubrey Rivera Gancia that I am now. Thank you, Mommy. And to my daddy, and to the Gancia Gancia, thank you for making it possible to be here. Say you're the last one. But this time, I can share all my achievements with you. I have always looked up to you, and I hope that with these laurels, you could feel in your heart how much I value your sacrifices and working up. Thank you, Daddy. I love you so much. And to our Almighty God, who has written the blueprints of our lives, thank you for all His blessings. Once again, congratulations to all of us.